Counter steering. Steering is simple enough. You push the bars in the opposite direction of the direction you wish to travel. That begins the turn, and the bike leans as it turns. Deliberately turning the bars in the opposite direction of travel is known as counter steering. Counter means against, and to steer means to guide or direct. To go right, you must turn the bars left. To go left, turn the bars right. Counter steering is the only way you can direct a motorcycle to steer accurately. This, in fact, is how you've been steering your motorcycle all the time, whether you knew it or not. You cannot steer a motorcycle simply by leaning it. You can get it to veer off in either direction by leaning your weight off to one side at low speeds, but that isn't steering. We're talking about controlling the bike, and that method is something less than control. You can only guess where the bike will go. At speed, you can't do much of anything if you're not holding onto the handlebars. Let's take a look at what happens when you steer. You're approaching a right-hand turn. You lean right, and the bike begins to go right. Since you're holding onto the bars and moving over to the right, your left arm is pulling the left side of the bars towards you, which turns the bars to the left. If you lean left to go around a left turn, you pull on the right bar. This must happen if you're holding onto the bars. If you're not holding the bars, the bike will not begin to turn where you lean. You may be pushing on the other bar as well as pulling. It depends on how you hold the bars. There is still great controversy over steering. Some say counter steering is the only way. Some say that body steering is the way. Whatever the future may bring for an answer to this debate, most everyone agrees that counter steering is the quickest, most direct, and efficient way of turning your motorcycle. Push-pull. As long as you continue pushing or pulling on the bars, the bike will continue to lean over and turn more sharply. When you ease the pressure on the bars, the bike will stay at the lean angle you reached when you eased up the pressure. You don't have to hold the bike into the turn with any great amount of force, if at all. On most bikes, once you have the machine at the desired lean angle, you no longer need to hold onto the bars. Actually, if you're riding 60 miles per hour on most bikes with a cruise control in a huge open parking lot with no bumps, you could take your hands off the bars once you had it leaned over, and the bike would continue going around in a circle at that lean angle until it ran out of gas. When you find yourself holding on very tightly in turns, you're doing a whole lot of unnecessary work. Bumps and other surface irregularities can change the situation, of course, so you do have to hold on to make steering corrections. I really glossed over the topic of rider input in this book. In Volume 2, it takes up 5 chapters. A lot of research has gone into this area. The point is that it's very important to begin to trust the bike to go around corners with as little input as possible once you've completed the steering. Tighten the turn. To tighten up a turn and increase your lean angle, you must counter steer again. You're in a right-hand turn, but it's a decreasing radius and you need to tighten it up. Now you must pull the bars to the left again until you reach the desired lean angle. The same applies in a left-hand turn. You must pull right and lean over more to tighten the turn. To straighten the bike up after finishing the turn, push the bars into the direction of the turn. Example, you're in a right-hand turn and want to go straight. Turn the bars to the right until the bike straightens out. Riders have problems with this, especially on fast, decreasing radius turns. They get into trouble, then try to force the bars in the direction of the turn. The major trouble riders have with decreasing radius turns is in not knowing how to steer. You can actually see riders climbing onto the tank, exerting a lot of pressure on the bars, trying to get it to turn. They become rigid as the bike goes further to the outside of the turn and makes them believe they're going too fast. You can see the effort, and you can hear the throttle being rolled off. Most turns can't be made without correcting for mistakes, camber or radius changes, or surface irregularities. Also, to hold a constant radius line through a turn which has changes, camber, bumps, etc., steering adjustments must be made. Most of your steering occurs with the original steering action going into the turn, but you must be able to correct the bike to compensate for sliding, changes in camber and radius, or other changes. If you can't correct the steering in a turn, it will limit you to a one-line-through-the-turn approach. Your speed and progress can be limited by how well or poorly you can correct the bike's direction. Any line has a maximum speed that can be ridden by a particular rider on a particular bike on a particular day. Having said that, let me ask a few questions. Do you think you make more steering corrections than is absolutely necessary to get through most turns? Are some of your steering corrections unnecessary? Would it feel better if you only had to make one steering input per turn?